Good afternoon. Today is Wednesday, May 22nd.
Now over to Janie with some more announcements.
Thank you. The quote of the day today is, "It is never too late to be what you might have been," by George Eliot. Lunch for today is chili and a hot combo of ham and cheese melt. And lunch for tomorrow are chicken tenders with no hot combo. Now over to your weather report.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Today is going to be sunny and tomorrow is going to be, you know, lightning-y, so don't raise your metal poles into the air.
Please do not. And today is also going to be a high of 74 and a low of 59, but tomorrow is going to be a high of 82 and a low of 63.
Now over to headline news.
You know the argument. On impeachment, Rick Wilson was on this broadcast a while back, said if they impeach the president, it fails in the Senate. Donald Trump raises $100 million off portraying himself as a victim of a coup and gets reelected. On the other hand, is the remedy for lawbreaking an election day? And on the other hand, have the public been invested enough in this story as written, as protected, as released to the public, and as we've all kind of muddled through it, what we know as the Mueller report?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. And that's what really gets to the heart of what impeachment is supposed to be about, right? So the framers put it in the House of Representatives, not in the court, not an independent, prosecutorial force, but in the House of Representatives. That does suggest that politics does play a part. It's not a judicial thing per se. A president doesn't have to break a specific law to be found guilty of high crimes and misdemeanors. Clearly, politics was envisioned as part of this process. So it's not unreasonable, perhaps, for the House Democrats to say, well, let's not go forward if we're not able to actually sway the, you know, a sizable number of the majority of the public and include people of the opposition party. One thing we've learned from past impeachments is, unless it's bipartisan, it doesn't work. And only 37%, I think, in one poll I saw, of the American public supports the idea of impeachment at this point. Having said that, there are consequences if they don't go forward, right? The consequences are, do we set a precedent in which we say all the things that President Trump has been accused of, if he, in fact, were found to be guilty of them, do not constitute impeachable offenses, because we didn't impeach him in this case. We didn't even try to. We didn't even have that debate. If we don't have that debate, does that mean future presidents have greater latitude to do all kinds of things that we used to think were not the kinds of things presidents should do? So there are consequences either way, in a short-term political consequence, and there's a long-term, jurisprudential, governance kind of consequence. And I don't know where that will fall, but that's what's going through the minds, I think, of a lot of people in Congress right now.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.
Attention juniors, if you're planning on taking AP Literature next year, please meet with Mr. Schenck in room 103 if you have not already met with him. You must meet with Mr. Schenck before the end of the year. Thank you. Attention freshmen, sophomore, and juniors. Reminder from our transportation office, you are responsible to keep your ID over the summer since you are utilized them at the beginning of the new school year to ride the bus. It is a good idea to take a picture of it so you have a digital copy as a backup plan. Thanks. Now over to viral video.
We're going to dog park. Yeah, we're going to go to dog park. You want to go? You want to go? You want to play with other dogs?
We go in the park to see the squirrels? What is your problem?
As of Friday, May 31st, you will have attain the title of senior. There are many exciting events during your senior year, and the first of those events involves your senior portrait. Senior portraits will be taken here by Life Touch Studio on June 3rd through the 6th. Each of you will email a postcard from Prestige with a specific appointment time. You must have your senior portrait taken in order to be in the 2020 yearbook. The list of all appointment times is also posted on the bulletin board outside of the main office and on the Class of 2020 bulletin board outside of the cafeteria. Please check the list for your appointment and make a note of it. It is very important that you are on time for your pictures. If you can't make your assigned appointment time, please see Ms. Martin in the main office to reschedule your appointment. Thanks. On Monday, the sports marketing class had a special presentation. Here are some highlights of the visit.
Things. I had to look something on his computer. Yeah, help yourself. Great. There you go.
All good right. Job. There you go. Very cool. Aww.
Oh my God.
Should see Mr. Mayo in room 224 regarding pre-semester reading materials for Western Civilization 2. These students should make a point of stopping by room 224 sometime this week. Annalise Bozert, Kara Staniker, J.N. Deem, Marissa Hirsch, Charles Janvern, Owen Linder, Eleanor Livingston, Blake Miller, Faith Poner, Joshua Rennenkamp, Anna Weiss, Joseph Williams, Amanda Yingling, and Jenna Yingling. Now over to CB Sports.
Today.
Go enjoy your day.
Now over to sports highlights.
Bucks facing the Toronto Raptors. Game four of this best of seven. The Bucks are up 2-1. The defending champs, the Golden State Warriors, waiting in the wings.
Look at Siakam. He gets the rebound. He's taking it himself, being aggressive.
Double teamed, and he lost it. Second consecutive turnover. And here's Giannis all the way sweeping around Gasol.
Right underneath the arm of Gasol.
Giannis got the step. Kawhi for the wide open, he buckled.
He doubled up on Leonard, and Leonard made Middleton's knees buckle on that play. So hard to anticipate which way Kawhi was going.
3 minutes to go. First half here in Toronto. Ibaka from straight away. Gasol with a nice pass, and Leonard puts it down and comes up limping. Heritage defending here on that leap. Shot clock to 5. Fires for 3. Oh, he hits first glass and then got the roll and a foul.
And I think that's going to send Ibaka to the free throw line.
Bad pass. Bucks turn it over. Powell on the drive. Eluding Connaughton. What a move. Lowry from way downtown. Kyle Lowry has been on fire. Leonard, yes. And back come the Raptors. Just under 4 remaining in the fourth. Lowry on the drive. Siakam getting it inside for Ibaka. It's all even at 2-2. The Bucks winning the first two in Milwaukee. Raptors take 2 here in Toronto. Game 5 back in Milwaukee on Thursday.
That's all the announcements we have for you today.
On behalf of WCBH, I'm Becca.
Alongside Nick.
And this is CB Today.
Have a windy Wednesday.
Another one. Celebrate for the ones we lost, yeah. Celebrate with the ones we got, yeah. Middle finger.